Hello everybody. Thanks for taking the time to watch the video of my camera that I have right here. And it's a Yashica. This used to be my father's camera. He passed away in 1997, and I'm just now getting around to dissipating some of his belongings. So with that said, I did something pretty stupid here, and I just want you to know that I'm not even an amateur. I like to take pictures. My camera that I'm taking this video on is a Canon D60. I have a GoPro, and I also have a drone. I enjoy taking pictures, but when it comes to photography, I'm self-taught, and I'm not even an amateur. Let's just put it that way. My camera is all automatic, and it does everything and thinks for itself. And if it wasn't for that, I would have to study it a little bit and understand what I'm doing. So with that said, going back to what I did, my stupidity here, I was very careless with this camera when I was unboxing everything, and I broke something off of it here. My heart went into my stomach. This little winder on the side of the camera right here, this little winder. Okay, what I did, somehow in my carelessness, I broke it. So here's the little spindle, and here's the handle, and it takes away from the camera. So I just was sick about it. But at any rate, I mean, it works good by turning it and with your thumb right here. But it's just aggravating. So with that said, I'm going to show you, take this out of its case here. I'll set this down. And I'll show you a couple other things here, but I think I'll zoom it in a little bit to get a better picture so you can actually see the camera more than I. All right, I actually just brought my camera, my Canon D60, a little bit closer because I wanted you to be able to listen to it. I told you that I'm less than an amateur on cameras, so I'm not going to explain this very well to everybody. The main thing I want you to do is at least to see that the functions on it work correctly and what all these different things are that they work, but I'm not in tune to exactly how to explain what all these things are, which I don't need to because you already know what you're looking at. So with that said, I'm going to take it out of its case and lift up these little metal ears. And then the case just comes right off, supposedly. Okay. So while we're closer, I'm just going to show you what I did to it in my carelessness. This winder, I don't know if you can see it or not, I broke the darn end of it off. So, you know, if you decide this is something that you want, I'm going to put this in a little plastic bag and put it with the camera. I don't know how you would put it back on, but you don't really need to, I suppose. It just depends what you're going to do with it. So when you wind it, it's easy to just grasp it and turn it. And then I noticed to make the shutter work, you have to turn it back the other way a half a turn. Then the shutter works. But if you don't turn, like in other words, I'm winding it, but if I don't turn it back the other way, the shutter release doesn't work. That's just the way it was intended to be used. And I'm sure that you know that. Okay, so this lens protector is kind of interesting too. It's made out of metal. And you lift up the bottom and you turn it and it comes off. I'm going to move all this stuff out of the way for the moment. Alright, so it has a self-timer on it, and it also has a thing up here that's got a red X and a yellow M. So I guess the M means manual. I don't know what the X means. Unless it means automatic. I don't know why they didn't put A instead of X. I told you I'm an amateur with this. So I put it on X and I move this little timer down at the bottom right here. I will wind it one revolution. Okay, it turned it back. So when I push on this button, you see the timer. And I hope you heard it. So the other thing is, I know that I'm going to get glare in the lens, and you're not going to be able to see real good from this. So when I take the back off, you'll be able to actually see the iris, or aperture, I guess you would call it, and the other. That's what these two things. This thing turns how long the shutter stays open. I think that's what this one does. And this one, how large or small the iris might be. So, this side over here has, oh yeah, this is, when I turn this button, that's how I guess you focus it. And then also there's another little wheel right here that turns. I don't know if you can see it or not. I'm doing my best to look at the camera viewer so I can see that I got the camera in the right position for you. But anyway, all that works really fine, easy. I don't know if I mentioned to you or not, this used to be my father's camera. He passed away in 1997, and I'm just now getting around to finding a home for some of his personal stuff. So, viewfinder over here, where you look through the, I guess it goes through and looks through the top part of this, just lifts up, and I think you can see inside there. But also I noticed, and I had to really play around with this to figure out how it worked. There's a little like magnifying glass, whoops, bring my finger up here, in here, right about here. And in order to get it to come out, you just push on the front right here, push on that, and it pushes it out. I think you saw that. I'll push it back in. It took me a while to figure all this out. All right, so with that said, I'm going to push the viewer back down. And again, I just want you to see that these things are operating. I'm not going to go into detail trying to explain anything because I think you would get fed up with me. All right, so anyway, there's a dial here, which I would imagine, because this is going in and out, is the zoom or focus maybe, and I guess I'm not sure. And then there's all kinds of dials on the side here, and they all move real easy. So I'm kind of, there we go. Well, anyway, they all move. You just have to be able to get your finger on it to turn it. All right, so what else about this? It has a light meter. I hope it's in focus, and I hope you can see it right here. You can see the needle. I'm moving a flashlight across it. A flashlight with dead batteries in it. There you can see, I think. So on this side over here, it does have a film counter, and by turning this, it's got a red line. I don't know if you could see that or not. And the red line means that it's actually winding the leader, and then it comes to number one. So, tip the picture, and now I'm winding it. And it's number two. Take the picture. And number three. Take the picture. And so on. So viewing the back of this camera, or the bottom of the camera, there's a little dial. And I have to be careful here because the light is reflecting off of the chrome. And then if I move it one way or the other too much, it's out of focus. So by turning this dial on the bottom of the camera, hopefully you can see that clear, what happens is this door has got a spring-loaded mechanism. See how it does? And when I turn the dial to open it, this lever comes out. And at the other end of that lever, I'm going to see if you can see that, there's a pin. And it is so clever because when you move this thing, it goes into the pin and locks it, but it actually goes, one way and then another way. It's just an amazing piece of engineering. I'm just really impressed. So I unlock that, and the door clears itself. It's just so amazing. And that little spring mechanism I was telling you about, I don't know here if you can see it, my fingers on it, right here. Little rod, spring-loaded rod that pushes against the door. So, hope that makes sense to you. What I'd like to do here with these pictures is to be able to show the aperture or the iris, whatever you call that. It's different openings, but the lighting and the focus and getting my hands around here to do this, a little bit of a trick. Almost need three hands. I can't really see what I'm doing from the angle that I'm sitting. I'm sort of guessing at this. Turn this knob the right way. So I have the iris or aperture open all the way so you can see as I fire off a shot here, the shutter speed. Whoops. Okay, so I'm just kind of randomly turning the dial. I can't see what I'm turning it to on the shutter speed. I hope you're able to see that. I hope this made sense. At any rate, that's my little camera for today. Thanks for watching the video.